Hi everyone. I hope with the unlocking of our cities going underway, you are all preparing to start your practice soon. Today we'll see a case of an unrestorable lateral incisor that needs to be extracted and replaced with an implant. Instead of doing the total extraction, what we will do here is a partial extraction, in which we will leave a thin sliver of the buccal part of the root inside the alveolus and then place the implant on the palatal aspect of the alveolus. What this will do is it will cheat the body into thinking that the tooth is still present, and that is why it will help us prevent the inevitable labial bone loss which happens with total extraction. My goal here is to provide you with a systematic approach towards partial extraction therapy so that you can set up your case for success. So now that we have seen the shield preparation being done, let me summarize the key points. The first and the foremost important rule in socket shield surgery is to see that the apex of the tooth is totally removed. And the second key point is to see that you internally bevel the shield to provide enough room for the soft tissue between the prosthesis and the shield. If you notice, when I prepared the shield, we thinned it out from inside for another reason, is that this is a very narrow socket of a lateral incisor, and we need to place a narrow diameter implant there. The cardinal rule of getting success in socket shield is to see that your implant does not touch the shield at all. There should be a gap of at least 1 millimeter, or preferably 2, between the shield and the implant. We'll be right back. we've got a good torque on the implant, we are able to provide a provision immediately on this implant so that there is an aesthetic replacement of this missing tooth. In part 2, I will show you how to make a provision on this implant and deliver it on the same day. For more in-depth knowledge on the surgical technique of partial extraction therapy, you can read the book that we have authored on this subject.